You know what's on my mind, girl. work it out like a runway. Gotta get it what they all say. Baby, wanna get it what they all say. West side girls love me. East side girls love me. Down south girls trust me. You got something lovely. All I wanna do is let go, let go. Baby, grab a hold.
Brilla para mí. Meu sol brilha para mim, queime a minha pele nas praias da Ubatuba. Nas praias da Ubatuba.
Just a bit. Thank you. That was hot. Make some noise for the Marinas brothers! And happy birthday, man.
It's not my birthday, it's his birthday. All right? So happy birthday, Chris. We love you, man.
Yo, Singapore, we love you so much. Thank you for coming out. We love you. You guys are beautiful, man. God bless you guys. Get home safe, all right?
I like this mic. I just want to keep talking. No, I'm just joking. Have a good night, man. We love y'all.
Thank you, Singapore, and the sound is not over because Phil Dark is taking back on the decks. Please make some noise for him. Hope the mics will work. Guys, thank you so much for tonight. I think it was very crazy vibe tonight. One of the highest buildings we've been, the Marina Bay Sands in Singapore, and one of the hottest sets we've ever witnessed with the Martinez brothers. Okay, guys, please don't hesitate to ask your questions live. We are live with the Martinez brothers. Don't hesitate to ask all your questions. There are so many questions for you guys.
Yeah, really?
Yeah,
we're going to try to answer more.
I think I won't ask any of my questions. It will only be the question from the audience.
Let's do it.
How do you feel, guys?
Man, this was incredible, man. The scenery, the people. You know, it was really a good vibe out here, man. So thank you guys for coming, man. Thanks to the public. Thank you guys. And yeah, can't wait to do it again for sure.
We are very, very happy to have you tonight. So a lot of questions. I'm checking all the questions. Question from Jorge. Do you plan your sets or choose on time? So did you prepare this set differently from usual because it was filmed or... Oh, it was improvised.
We've never ever planned a set in our lives, like ever. Like for us, that's a no-no. You know what I'm saying? You have to feel the vibe in the moment. You know, we seen the environment, we felt the people, and like we just play what we feel at the moment. You know what I'm saying? I think that's the best way to go. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes if you plan stuff, you know, it might not work for that moment.
Yeah,
you know
of course.
What I'm saying? So you have to feed off the crowd. That's how we learned. You know what I'm saying? That's how our forefathers taught us. You know what I'm saying? So. Yeah, that's just the way we do it, you know what I mean?
Is it the first time you come at Marina Bay Sands here? Is it the first time you come at Marina Bay Sands on the top
yes,
of this building?
Yes, this is like the first time, man. Like, we've been here, we remember when it first got built, Yeah. It was like a big hype, you know what I'm saying? So it's cool now, 10 years later, to be able to, you know, perform on here. It's amazing.
It was really crazy and
that was very, great. Was very great. Hot was great.
Tonight. I'm checking all the other questions. Question not related to music. What is your favorite Singaporean food?
Yo, you know what? That's a good question.
That's difficult.
But you know what? This is only our second time here.
Yeah.
So we don't really know too much about the Singaporean food. Having said that, we heard that there's some amazing Chinese food here.
Yeah.
So that's all.
Like Singapore is such a mixture of different cultures, you know, Indian, just like Asian in general, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we love Indian food, we love Chinese, we love Asian food in general, so we're going to eat a lot tomorrow.
Yeah. So don't hesitate to send your suggestions, Cherry. Don't hesitate. And yeah, you were talking about cultural diversity. Of course, here in Singapore, there is a lot of diversity. You created a label. After you created your own label, you created a label with Seth Troxler. Knowing that and seeing that there wasn't enough cultural diversity, do you feel that now in dance music industry, it's better?
I feel like, you know, there's a lot of diversity right now, but no matter what, we always want to keep pushing our culture forward. You know what I'm saying? You know, we love to, you know, show you guys, you know, what we're about, and hopefully, you know, you guys can accept it and, you know, feel what we feel, you know what I'm saying, at the end of the day. So we just want to spread love no matter what, you know, whether it's a certain type of culture or not, and
show different types of music, you know what I mean? We're all about like different types of music, you know. We don't just play house music.
Yeah.
We play techno, we play disco, you know what I'm saying? We listen to Brazilian, African, anything, tribal music, like we like to, you know, just bring it in as much as possible, you know, just all different types of things, you know what I'm saying? So we get bored easily, so we love to bring other cultures into our music as well. So it's really important.
I mean, one of your last track, Bappi, with is very orientally inspired. Yes. Where did you get the vocals from?
So we got the vocal. The man's name is actually Bappi. He's a famous Indian Bollywood composer, and like, you know, that song is really famous in India, Jimmy. And it was actually Jamie who actually brought the sample and was like, "Yo, we should put this in this track." And we loved it, and it worked, and it's like we're glad.
Shout out to Jamie, the God.
We love you, bro. And it's just, you know, I'm glad that people are receptive to it. You know,
it's a crazy track. Definitely.
Yeah, man, love you, love.
Question from. Oh my God, there
Philippe,
is someone.
Leave us alone, Philippe.
He's mixing, but he's calling me with his
Come
iPhone.
Come on, man, mix your track,
not
bro.
On purpose. So it's crazy. I don't know how to stop. Oh no, I know what I will do. Something like this, maybe it will work. Calm down. Question from Daniela. What's the one item you two can't travel without?
Ralph Lauren polo, baby.
What?
You know what I mean? Ralph Lauren polo. We're in some bait right now, but you know what I'm saying? Like, we're low heads at the end of the day, so some Ralph Lauren polo, that's always in my suitcase. You know what I'm saying? How about you, Stevie? What you can't travel without?
The one item I can't travel without is my face wash. If I don't bring my special face wash, or my special, I'm just gonna be like breaking out and shit. So you don't want to see that. I'd rather just clean my face properly. I'm just being real.
Okay, question from Marcus. Your three favorite records of all time.
Wow.
That's fine, we have some time.
First of all, that's very, very difficult. I'm just gonna give you three favorite records off the top of my head. Number one, Candido, Thousand Finger Man. Just cause it reminds me of my dad, you know what I'm saying? Cause that's one of his favorite records. And that's one of the first records he introduced us to when it comes to disco and house music. The second record has to be, there's a 45 by the TNJs called Falling in Love, which is a very, very incredible record. You guys should hear it if you haven't heard it. It's incredible. The third record, I would say Slum Village, Players, J Dilla. We're huge J Dilla fans, so anything J Dilla is our favorite, but this particular track is very, very top. You know what I'm saying? Like, very intense. Like, it's hard. We don't know how he made it, so. Slum Village, J Dilla, Players. Woo, woo!
Your turn.
Dude. Listen, man. This is hard. I'm over here, like, Rolodexing records. This is hard. Let's skip to the next question. I'll come back to it.
Okay.
All right. Powerline, Double Journey. Damn. Giant Steps by John Coltrane. And let's see. Some Chick Corea, Windows. Great track. We love jazz. We love all types of music. We could be here all day. I'm just naming tracks off the top of my head. But we just love all types of music, man.
Do you like techno?
Jodeci, everything.
Yeah. Jeff Mills, Transformation. Steely Dan, I don't know, Kenny Larkin, whatever. Like, we like anything, bro. Like, it's, don't ask us those questions. You can go all day, man.
Question from Swen, Dichi. Question from the brothers. Can you imagine yourself on stage together with some techno duo such as Fiac and combine their music with your music, with different style?
Dude, I mean, listen, what you've seen today is just a small aspect of, you know, what we like musically, you know? We were here, we were by the sea, we were by the pool, you know, we were playing some deep sounds, you know what I'm saying? But don't get it twisted, man. When we get in the club and we're playing 12 hours, we're playing all types of things, you know what I'm saying? Like, we love techno, we love all types of music, like we said. So, you know, if you see one set, you know, don't make that the judgment, you know? Because we love all types of music, man, and we play different types of things.
You don't know what you're gonna get. You don't know where you're going to get when you see
yeah,
us.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, we really don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, we go everywhere, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, we love techno, love, you know what I'm saying? We love all types of music, like we said.
Last question. I think your career took off after a video from that was posted on Defected Records. So it was really a video. What do you think of the status of video in the dance music industry? Do you think it should be more or less?
We should be more, you know what I'm saying? Should be more. We were just talking about we have to do a video for one of the tracks that we just released with Louis, you know what I'm saying? And like you said, that Defected video, that's what really got people, you know, talking about us and actually finding out about us, you know what I'm saying? So if it wasn't for YouTube and social media, we wouldn't even be here, you know what I'm saying? Because like, it was social media that connected us to Dennis Ferrer and connected us to playing at the Shelter and like, you know, it snowballed into other things. So, you know, shout out to social media, you know what I'm saying? And YouTube and all that.
Yeah.
Like he said, like, we would always be in our house on YouTube searching, you know, other DJs, Dennis Ferrer, Masters at Work, like so many legends that we would always just watch just to see what's going on. You know what I'm saying? Like when YouTube just came out, we always just wanted to find out, yo.
We wanted to find out what was actually going on in the clubs because we were so young, we couldn't get in. So we would try to find videos of people in our DJs in the club, you know what I'm saying? Like, we wanted to see what was going on inside, you know what I mean?
Timmy registered, everything.
Exactly, so it was like, very important.
And now we have a crazy, crazy video of you playing here. Woo! So we are very happy. We are very happy of that.
Yo, we love
Thank
you, guys.
You so much.
We love
for
you. Yo, God bless you guys, man. God bless you. God bless
Thank
you.
Thank you so Thank much. You. We have Thank a little you. Tradition. It's yes. the mystery box. So. The mystery box is a gift.
Okay. Oh, shit.
Of course, first is the cake, but the mystery box is coming.
Wow. Right. The mystery box. What's going on over here, man? Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
So it's a gift from C'est la vie, from this venue.
Open it now?
Yeah. It's
some sake?
A sake.
Some sake to me, baby.
It's a sake made for C'est la vie, so thank you so much, C'est la vie, for trusting us and welcoming us.
We're getting drunk now? You're going to get drunk?
Yes, definitely,
all
man.
All right, cool, yeah, so let's do it.
Thank you so much to you
thank
guys,
you guys.
For
you.
Watching, to all the media partners that will come up on the screen. We are very happy about this Asia debut with the Martinez brothers. Thank you so much, and see you very soon. Bye-bye, guys.
Yes, peace.